Hello everyone, my name is Muskan. I am a legal intern at LexClick & Company. So today's topic of discussion is retail equality, which comes under Article 14-18 under the Constitution of India. So let's proceed with our topic. So first question comes into our mind is, what is retail equality? Democracy can only thrive and flourish where the individuals in the society are treated equally and without discrimination. Thus, it was felt by framers of the Constitution to incorporate such provision to remove the hurdle of existing social and economic inequalities and enable the diverse communities of the country to enjoy the rights and liberties granted under the Constitution. It was believed to be essential to remove inequalities based on religion, social norms, age, or tradition practiced in parts of India like untouchability, casteism, race discrimination, etc. The right to equality means the absence of legal discrimination only on the grounds of caste, race, religion, sex, and place of birth, and they ensure equal rights to all citizens. It is considered a basic feature of the Indian Constitution. The right to equality is both a positive equality and as well as negative right. Under the Indian Constitution, right to equality is divided under the following subheadings. Equality before law, Article 14, prohibition of discrimination on the basis of caste, religion, sex, Article 15. Equality of opportunity in matters of public employment, Article 16, abolition of untouchability, Article 17, abolition of titles, Article 18. Under the right to equality, Article 14 provides a general application whereas Article 15, 16, 17 and 18 have a specific application. Right to equality under Article 14. The state shall not deny to any person equality before law, equal protection of law within the territory of India. Article 14 tries to achieve the equality of status for all the people. It may aims at establishing the rule of law in India. This guarantee available to both citizens and non-citizens. It applies to all persons, natural as well as juristic. Right to equality, Article 14, equality before law. It is taken from English common law. This implies the absence of any special privileges in any person, implies no discrimination before the law on opposite ground like rank, office, etc. It means that law should be equal and should be equally administered, that the like should be treated alike. State that every individual is subject to the jurisdiction of ordinary courts irrespective of their rank or position. Equal protection of law. It is corollary from equality before the law. It is based on the last clause of the first section of 14th Amendment of U.S. Constitution. It directs that equal protection should be secured to all persons within the territorial jurisdiction. This implies that such protection should be without any favor or discrimination. This implies equal treatment in similar circumstances, both in privileges and liabilities imposed by law. It is a positive obligation of the state which it should achieve by bringing about necessary social and economic changes to ensure that every person enjoys such equal protection. Rule of law. The principle of Article 14 equality before law to a large extent based on the concept of rule. Supremacy of law. There should be an absence of arbitrary power and there that no person should be punished except for a breach of law. An offense should be proved by the authorities of the country before the ordinary courts to punish him according to legal procedure. Equality before law. All individuals, irrespective of their rank or position, poor, rich, officials or non-official sector, should be subjected to ordinary law of land which is administered by ordinary courts. It seeks to ensure that law is administered and enforced in a just and fair manner. It has also been embedded in the preamble and Article 7 of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. It implies law gives equal justice to all. The predominance of legal spirit. The IC believe that there should be an enforcing authority to enforce effectively the above two principles. According to whom such enforcing authority should be called exceptions to the rule of law. Delegated legislature, administrative adjudication, underlying principle, legislative classification, test of valid classification, and application of Article 14, and basis of classification. Next, prohibition of discrimination on the basis of caste, religion, sex, etc. Article 15. This state shall do no discrimination on the basis of ground, creed, religion, etc. that is available against state. Protection under this provision can be taken by any citizen when he is subjected to discrimination in relation to any rights, liability, or privilege conferred to it by the Constitution. Religious or racial disability in connection with access to soap, sex, sector. Article 15 subclause 2. No citizen shall on the ground only of religion, race, caste, sex, place of birth or any of them he be subjected to disability liability restriction or condition with regard to access to shop, public restrooms, hotels and places of public entertainment, the use of wells, tanks, bathing ghats, roads and places of public resort, maintain the holy pathway of the state funds or dedicated to the use of general public. Special provisions for women and children reply that Parliament has the right to make special provisions. This article is an exception to rule against discrimination. The intention of framers of the Constitution was to protect the interest of the children and women because these sections were considered comparatively weaker section of society and the need for such provision was felt by the upliftment. The language of the clause is in absolute terms and gives the power to state to make any special provisions and laws for the protection of the interest. Such special provisions are not restricted in any sense and need not be measures that are beneficial in a strict sense. Special provision for socially and economically backward classes. Reservation to educational institutions. Equality of opportunities in matter of public employment. Article 16. There should be equality of opportunity for all citizens in matter relating to employment or appointment to any office under the state. No citizen shall on the grounds of religion, race, caste, sex, descent, place of birth, residence or any of them be ineligible or discriminated against in respect of any employment or office under the state. Nothing in this article shall prevent the Parliament from making any law prescribing regard to class or classes of employment or appointing to any office under the government of or any local or under authority within the state or union territory or any requirement as a residence within that state or union territory prior to such employment appointment. Nothing in this article shall prevent the state from making any provision for the reservation or appointment or post in favour of any backward class of citizens which is in open new state is not adequately presented in a service under the state. Nothing in this article shall affect the operation of any law which provides that the incumbent of office is in connection with the affairs of any religious or denominational institution or any member of the governing body. Thereof shall be a person professing a particular religion or belonging to a particular dominion nation. Next, abolition of untouchability. The word and the untouchability in this clause has been used in interpretive commerce, which indicates that word should be constructed in literal or grammatical sense, but with reference to its historical background in accordance with the Article 35 of the Constitution, Parliament has been given the power to make laws prohibiting such acts of untouchability. Exercising the powers and duty conferred in Article 17 and 35, the following acts which are made by Parliament from time to time. Abolition of title, not being a military or academic decision, shall be conferred by the state. No citizen of India shall accept any title from any foreign state. No person who is not a citizen of India shall, while he holds any official property of the trust under the state, accept without the consent of president and title from the foreign state. No person holding any office of profit or trust under the state shall, without the consent of the president, accept any present and emolument or office of any kind from the under any foreign state. That's conclude our topic. The court that are considered the guardians of the Constitution make certain that such right to equality is construed in the widest connotation so as to achieve the ends intended by the framers of Constitution. That's all for today. If you like my video, do like, comment and subscribe to the Let's Click Kid Up channel. Thank you.